Hi there. In this video, we are going to cover how to make your emails look pretty when you send them in n8n. So something that I've seen a lot of people making a mistake on when they're sending emails is that they'll have something like this, right? So they have a chat, some sort of input, they'll have an AI write the email, they'll send the email, but then you get back something that doesn't exactly look very nice. It doesn't look formatted at all. And I'll give you an example. So let's just go ahead and open the chat. Send an email to Jim saying that I look forward to meeting him next week, just as an example. All right, so it drafts the email for me. Hi, Jim, I hope this finds you well. Just want to say that I am looking forward to meeting you next week. Best regards, my name. My system prompt is just you write nice emails for the user, output a JSON object. I'm doing a JSON object because I have the structured output parser here, in order to make sure that I get a subject and a body. So that way it writes both for me. And so here we see it's sending it to me. I just set it to me rather than having to figure out who to send it to. Here's my subject, json.output.subject, json.output.body. And I'm set to HTML. So like here I've got my backslash ends that should be line breaks, right? It should be spaced properly. But if I come over to my email, here's looking forward to meeting you. Hi, Jim. I hope this message finds you well. I just want to say I'm looking forward to meeting you next week. Best regards. It's all on one line. Like, what happened? And a lot of the videos that I'm seeing on YouTube, a lot of the workflow creators I'm seeing are just like, oh yeah, that's good enough. It's sending emails. But like, that's not cool. Like, I don't want it to look janky like that. I want my emails to look pretty, right? Maybe like throw in some bold, throw in something. So I'm going to show you exactly what to do. Now, The key to this is this one right here. Under the Gmail node, you have email type of HTML. You can also do it as text. If you set it to text, it will literally only send text. It won't send any formatting whatsoever. But like, I have it set to HTML. So like, why is it not working, right? Like, it should be working in my mind. Backslash end is HTML. That's because it's just not formatted right. It just isn't formatted to be able to do it right. So we're gonna do this. We're gonna come here, we're gonna change up our system prompt in my email agent. So the one writing my emails. Now, what you can also do is you can have something write the thing that you're writing and then have another agent after that format in HTML. So we're gonna say format this strictly in HTML, strictly in HTML. With proper HTML marks, such as paragraph and others. Add bolding when necessary, headers as well. So let's try that again. We'll test it. And our output here is a paragraph. Hi, Jim. And then we got slash paragraph. Paragraph, I just want to let you know, I look forward to meeting you next week. All right, and here we even have a break. All right, so let's go ahead and send that. All right, we'll come back over to my email. Check it. Looking forward to meeting you next week. Hi, Jim. I just want to let you know I'm looking forward to meeting you next week. Best regards. So there we go. It's beautiful, isn't it? And it, like, it's actually properly has the right breaks in it. It's supposed to, and it doesn't have to do just breaks. So I have a report generator that I have it add actual character and flavor to my email. So here it's got give me a, I think this is a heading two. It's got italics. It's got bold. It's exactly what I was hoping for. Once I was able to figure this out, because before, like, if I go back far enough, my daily reports. Not that one, not far enough back. Let's go even further back in time. Okay, daily reports. It was just yucky text. It was just one big long string of text. And I thought I was setting it up right. I thought, because like I told it to like add bolding and add whatever. And so you'll see here, we got my two asterisks. Well, that's markdown formatting. The slash n is markdown formatting. Most likely y'all been doing this wrong. You need to make sure you're doing HTML formatting. And that needs to be done to the text before it ever gets to the email sender, all right? So if you wanna make your emails look better, whatever agent is right before you're sending that email, make sure that you're telling it that it needs to output its response in HTML formatting. So something that I might do is I'll often process reports, big old reports that I want to include in the email, but I don't necessarily want the agent that's making the report to put it in HTML because I don't want it to have to try to think of two things at once. I want it to do just one thing. So in that case, what I would just do is I would just come over here, I break that, I would add in a new AI agent, and I would say define below my subject. We'll just do something like subject, add that here, and then we would come over and body come over here, and I would come to my system prompt and I would say keep all the text exactly as it is, just reformat this into proper HTML formatting. And you don't necessarily need anything far more complicated than that. I'd probably go to ChatGPT to clean it up a little bit. And even for something like this, the model I would use would be super small. So not a 4.0 mini, not even a 4.1 mini. I would actually probably go 4.0 nano, just because it's super, super small. I don't need it to think at all. I just need it to add formatting. So I run that. It does it. There we go. Ooh, that's an interesting one. It did try to add incorrect. It did this incorrectly. So no, let's see, doc type HTML, just proper P and breaks and headers. Let's see if that fixes it. All right, there we go. So I got my P, my slash P for end of my paragraph. With my line breaks in it. So let's try one more time. Send myself another email. Oh, you can't read it because it's not set to the right thing. We'll just do test and then we'll do this just to test it. Right? Test. And we sent me another email. Back to the top. Email. There we are. Test. And there, it formatted it exactly like it was supposed to. All right. That is how you can make your emails look pretty from now on. So if you've been struggling with getting your emails to just stop being on a single line and you're like, it's probably good enough. There you go. Just make sure that you set it to be formatted as HTML output. And if you found this video helpful, please make sure to subscribe to the channel. Be sure to like and share the video to get this content out there to those who need it. It really does help. Also, be sure to click the link in the description below to join my free school community where I give additional tips and tricks on how to use n8n, as well as over 25 different n8n workflows to be able to develop your marketing plan, to be able to process product data, to be able to do all kinds of really cool things as a business, including a really cool personal assistant bot that I've spent a lot of time working on just for you. All right, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.